welcome to Money Control. This is Shraddha Sharma and you're watching Reporter's Take. In today's edition, we'll discuss loan for consumer durable goods. And for that, joining us is Money Control's Parnika Sokhi. Hi Parnika, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
So what was the trend like during the festive season?
So the festive season has been really good in terms of sales of consumer durables, like we saw some companies actually revealed their sales figures. We saw that impact on the loans as well. So the loans which were taken to purchase these consumer durables have actually gone up, they've shown a good amount of rise in the past few months. So if you look at RBI data from August till August, September, October, these 3 months going into the festive season, the growth has been around 70% higher as compared to last year. Now why is this important? It's because before this, we've actually seen contraction in the consumer durable loan growth in line with the general economic slowdown.
All right, since you said the consumer durable loan has actually gone up, what does it mean for the banks?
So it's good news for banks, obviously, because they've not been seeing any corporate growth on the side of corporates, and in terms of retail lending also, they're mostly all dependent on home loans or, you know, personal loans.
Right.
So something of this sort is definitely a positive for banks, and it does support the overall loan credit growth for them.
All right, so overall credit loan has actually gone up, but what is the outlook?
So it might not really be able to sustain itself going forward. Why? Because these sellers had actually discounted a lot of these goods, like, you know, refrigerators and ACs during the festive season, and that's why we saw the spurt in the sales volume, and all these discounts have now been rolled back. So it might be possible that we might go back to the normal growth numbers going ahead.
And might not be sustainable, as you said. Thank you, Parnika, for joining us with those insights. That's all for today's episode of Reporter's Take. For more news, views and updates, stay logged on to moneycontrol.com. Thanks for watching.